Hello and welcome to the channel. I'm Rob.
And I'm Colette.
And today we're having a little brief encounter with the railway. I hope it's not too windy. I've got the muffler on. Just bear with us here. We've just got to cross this track here. Look at this. So we're just walking over the railway line. It is a marked out path. You do walk across this. It is set out for that. Anyhow, back to the intro. So what are we doing today, love?
We're going to a train station.
We're going to a train station. Well, not just any train station.
No.
It's probably one of the most famous train stations in Lancashire for filming. And there was a great film that was filmed there in the 1940s. And what was the film called?
Brief Encounter
by...
A love story.
Oh, yeah. Let's get in here. I think it's too windy. Go on. Right, let's start again. So go on, tell us more about this film.
No, it's a love story.
Oh.
It's a brief encounter.
It's not a tearjerker, is it?
It is a bit, but I won't tell you the ending, because that will spoil it.
So if it was
filmed... But it is a love story.
If it was filmed in the 1940s...
1945.
Then it'd be a black and white film.
It is black and white.
We're not watching it when we get there, are we?
Well, you can. You can actually sit and watch it, because it's on loop all day.
Right, so why was it filmed in Carnforth?
Because... it was filmed in 1945 in the height of the war.
Well, yeah.
So where they wanted to film it in London, they couldn't because of the blackouts. They needed light, obviously, to film.
Well, yeah, it'd be a giveaway, that, wouldn't it?
A little bit. So they came to Carnforth and filmed there.
So I think you said as well before, when I was asking you about it, that they only filmed outside at Carnforth because all the inside stuff... was filmed in London.
In London, in a studio.
In the studios
but
in London.
What they did was, the cafe, they actually rebuilt as a cafe in this train station.
So we're going to see
so
that?
So yeah, it is built as you would see in the film.
Great. And hopefully we might see some steam trains. I don't know.
It's famous for its steam trains as well.
So we'll have a look in here when we get there. But in the meantime, we're waiting for our train. Because we're going to get on a train too. Yeah, would you like to get on a train with us?
but it's not a steam train.
It's not a steam train, unfortunately.
Yeah, not today.
No, it might be late, it might be cancelled, you know what they like.
Don't, let's not go there.
Right, we'll see you shortly when we're on the train. So we've just got into Carnforth. Colette's just bringing our luggage in.
It's heavy work.
So it's all set up, isn't it? Like, you know, all the 1940s. Yeah, right.
Yeah, I've just heard
me. It's all set up like the 1940s, isn't it?
What we've got to show them
is
a round brass plate we found, and it said Carnforth.
Oh yeah.
To Manchester.
Yeah.
And we think, because it's a tip local.
Yeah.
That we think that it's something to do with the railways, don't we?
Yeah. Yeah, we'll see if we can come across one of them.
Yeah, or show it.
So, it's all set up here like the oldie world of the 1940s. And there's a bit of a museum here as well.
Probably before, when you think it's... How long has the train station been open?
Oh, 18... Oh, you've got me there. Was it 1887 or 1897? I'll have to check. What I'll do, I'll put it up here when it was open. I was just getting out there to the that train.
Yeah.
I was hoping that we might find some steam trains while we're there. But if we don't, there's a place just a bit further up the road where there's some bigger steam trains in that we can go up there and visit them and have a look at them. Look at this. This looks like the old station. Do you want to take a seat there and... sort out the household bills, my love. Oh, look at the laptop.
Oh, this is a nice laptop, isn't it?
It suits you, that. So, there used to be a steam town here, wasn't there?
Yeah, they had to close it in 1997.
Yeah. So they had a place called Steam Town, and this looks part of it here. I'm just looking out on the TV. But they had to close that down in 1997 for health and safety reasons because it was just too industrial. They had all the diesel trains there and piles of coke and everything. And they just couldn't have the public walking about there anymore.
No. Hey, look at that.
What's that?
A smoking cabinet.
With Adam's tobacco jar.
Yeah, a retirement gift.
Yeah. So, we're not sure what footage we filmed. We wanted to do the brief encounter, but there's so much memorabilia here from the steam age. It's just blown us away, really. So we're going to get some of that footage on as well for those of you that are into your steam, Victorian steam. And there's pictures here of everything, isn't there? Yeah, all the old railway ones up there. Yeah. Another room here with a waiting bench. And there's just all sorts here. Look at the signals. Look at the old signal there. Wow. The home signal arm. Oh yeah, there's some buttons here.
I've just seen something there. That's interesting.
Can you find the one that we found? That looks like it there, number 20. See it at the top?
That's all
that. Oh, you just got in the...
And I've just realised.
That one there, see it?
Number 20?
Yeah, just above where it says number 20, the big round one.
Oh, right, I was going to say that, ours is bigger.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It doesn't look like
and
that,
and we found
it
in a local tip, didn't we?
Oh, look at the old insulator. It's got LMS on it. That is cool. Look at that.
Got one of them at home, haven't we?
Not with LMS on.
No, we haven't. It's not got any writing on. Look at that.
Yeah, the old flask.
Yeah.
The London, Midland and Scottish LMS. For those that are wondering. Look at these bottles. A couple of bottles here.
I've got the account for them.
Because they've even got a coat hanger with LMS on.
LMS Hotels?
Yeah.
And look at that.
Oh,
a wine matchbox
box
holder, an ashtray.
Just look at this air clap. See all the lights coming through on that?
Oh, it's
look at that. That's a picture and a half,
yeah,
isn't it?
Yeah, I'd love one of them.
Look at that. The old paraffin lamp.
Nice.
That is nice. I really like that. I like the way the light's going through the window and making it look like it's lit up.
Has that got Carnforth on it?
No, it's just Derby. Oh, look at the old signal the for the switching lines. I won't touch them. Wow.
And the hats.
What hats? Oh, these.
That applies to you, Rob.
Please do not let your parents play with the exhibits. Wow. Let's go in here and see what's in here. There we go. That's a good sign. So is this a pub section just in here?
I must have come in that way.
Look at this tilt. We're getting a drink while we're here.
Yeah.
What's this been?
I don't know,
it's like
a room.
It's probably
just sitting and having coffee here.
Yeah, it would have been the waiting room, wouldn't it?
Oh, yeah, yeah. The flooring. Proper Victorian.
Yeah.
Thailand.
So they would have had the fire on. They were waiting for trains to come in.
Yeah.
Wow. They've really done it out nice, haven't they?
Done it lovely. Really nice.
I was just looking at that there. Look at the size of that up. Using it as a door stopper. That's good though. So we've got to have a coffee break while we're here, haven't we?
Oh yeah. Nice.
So we'll have this coffee and then we'll move on to the other session, because I'm sure there's more to this place than what we've seen already. So this is probably the smallest cinema in the world. It's got like 3, 6, 9 seats.
These chairs were donated from Mark and Winter Gardens.
Oh, right. We were there the other week, weren't we? When the vintage weekend, when we did that video.
Yeah, they probably want them back
now. Yeah, they probably want them back. So, yeah, it's probably the smallest cinema in the world, this. And apparently this film, I don't know if it's been picked up on the camera, the Brief Encounter film, this is played on a loop, like... well, is it? Is it just played all day, every day?
I think so, yeah.
So, you'll never miss it. Look at that. Bit of popcorn for YouTube video. Oh, look at that, I found one of them. I found one of them the other week, but it was in half. It was exactly the same. For freedom and honour, yeah. 1919. Oh, that's a complete one. Yeah. Oh, that's unbelievable. Little miniature poison bottle. Don't know if you can hear me now, it's getting a bit busier here. There's some old milk bottles there as well. Look at them. But yeah, that's unbelievable coming across one of them. Have to be finding one the other week. That's great.
Dig on for victory.
We've
tried that, haven't we? We wasn't successful.
We're just starting
more.
The old man. Please do not mess with my mangle.
Money was usually quickly spent on sweets at the local tuck shop. A Mars bar in the mid-50s could be had for 6 old pets.
You can't spin either.
Sorry about that.
Can't spin.
Hey Colette, go in that there.
Darling.
Oh no.
I'll meet you in another life. I had grit in my eyes.
Will I ever see you again?
No, I'm afraid not.
Oh, that was a brief encounter.
You're supposed to sit that one.
Bye, my love.
Bye.
Will I ever see you again?
No.
Okay, that's good. Oh, you can dress up, can't you? We like to dress up, don't we?
Oh, no. Here we go.
Look at these here. Look at this. Oh, here's the film set. Oh, somebody's done a little model of when they were filming it. That's so cool. Oh, it's great, isn't it? Look at these. I like that one.
Good size of that reflector.
Wow.
Never found one that big.
No. So there we go, that was the little museum of the Brief Encounter. Where's the clock? Isn't there a clock somewhere? Shall we see if we can find the clock?
I don't think it's here. I don't know why.
I heard that it got taken away for repair and it's never come back.
That's a shame because it's famous for the clock as well, isn't it?
And I did buy some coal. Where's my coal?
He thought it was cold. It's actually licorice.
It's sweets.
Oh, what's some coal?
I thought they were just little gimmicks of little bits of coal. And when we come out, said they were sweets.
It's so. Licorice fudge.
Yeah.
So that's not good for you.
Right, let's get down here and see if we can find anything else. So, it's a bit windy, isn't it?
It's not so nice today.
So we've been in there, haven't we? That's where we got our coffee before.
Yeah, the famous Brief Encounter.
Tell you what, in the film, that woman was running up these steps, weren't she? Up this slope.
Yeah, up the slope.
Can you remember it? Do you want to do a little run for us, love?
No.
Go on, just halfway down. All right, go.
She was going for a
train, yeah.
We have actually seen the film.
We've seen the film.
To be fair.
Wow. No, I'm going to miss my train. Come on. This is our side, actually.
This is our train?
This is where she ran up.
Come is it?
Yeah.
Come
on. Come on. You're going to miss your train. Will I ever see you again?
No, the train's actually in. Come on,
let's get it.
I know, just nearly jumped on that train then. It's not even our train.
So I know it's a bit windy, but I'm gonna just try and film a bit of this the best I can. Because Carnforth was also the major railway depot in the days of steam. And the last in Britain to remain open when British Rail ceased using steam in 1968. Later it became Steamtown Railway Museum, which is just over there at the back. And that's now been shut down. That got shut down in 1979. There's several buildings here that have been listed, like that there, the old water tower. That's a grade one listed building. The wagon works, the water tower, which I just said, the coaling tower. Now that's that one there, just over the trees. That's the coaling tower. The ashing plant. And there's a preserved signal box from the cell side. I think I tried videoing that on the way in. That's just, oh, there it is there. I'll see if I can zoom into it now. The remaining operational signal box to the north of the station. So that's that there. And there's the old steam town in the distance. Shortly down there. Where's my coal?
In my pocket. I've been looking at the contents of that and it's not good.
Colette's getting a lot of Colette's getting steamed up. So we promised you steam today.
We got it.
I think we found a steam train. So are you alright?
Wow.
Is it getting up your nose?
Just a bit.
It's only steam, it'll do you no harm.
I know, but there's a smell of coal.
So yeah, I think we found ourselves a steam train.
Definitely.
As promised. So we'll show you the steam train now. And if you're wondering... we need to do this intro.
Right, I'm doing it.
Well, it's not an intro, it's just... anyhow...
We're just showing we found steam.
Yeah, we're just trying to show you we found steam, basically.
Oh, Lordy.
If you're wondering why we're doing a video on steam trains, as well as what we've just done on the brief encounter, at the end of the day, it is all part of the Industrial Revolution, isn't it? And without the industrial, without the steam, we wouldn't even have an Industrial Revolution, because it was steam that powered everything to what we've got today. So, I don't know if we're going to get on this train. I don't know if you're allowed on it.
You are. I've looked.
Oh, have you had a look around?
Yeah, you can do a train ride on that.
So, and you know what? I know this is actually in the South Lakes. It comes under Cumbria. But before 1974, this was actually Lancashire. And it still has the postcode LA. So, that's what confused me. You know when I put it in the map?
Yeah.
It said LA and I thought, oh, it's still Lancashire. But when we got here, it said it was Cumbria.
Yeah, because it's actually in Backbower, yeah. Isn't it?
So we're just going to get a few shots around here for you, and then hopefully we can get on this steam train and have a bit of a ride.
Yeah.
So that's the ticket office over there, isn't it?
Yeah.
So if we can get a ticket and get on this train, that could be quite something else, couldn't it?
Yeah.
They do all sorts. They've got cafes, they've got all sorts of...
Have they?
Yeah.
So, beautiful coal. It's probably been imported that now, hadn't it, from another country.
Yeah.
Which is a shame, really, because when you think the amount of coal we used to produce, and now we've got to import coal ourselves.
Right, so if we go down here, I think there's some other kind of tables and that.
This is old. You know, isn't it?
It's like the wood and everything, isn't it?
I wish my Manchester train was this empty when I got Manchester.
Yeah, but it feels like we've got the train to ourselves. I wonder if they'll let us dress up and do like an Agatha Christie movie.
Oh, you wouldn't
something.
See that anymore, do you? Like, here. I know it's something, nothing.
Yeah.
There, do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
On modern trains, you wouldn't see that.
It's where the coupling is, where they join them together. But yeah, I think, should we sit here? This looks nice.
Number 29.
Choo-choo. Oh, these are comfy.
Are we sitting here now?
Yeah,
are you sure?
I think we found a seat.
Are you absolutely sure?
Look at the lake. Look at that.
Mm.
Look at the lake.
Lovely, isn't it?
Are we back on that scene again, a brief encounter? Will I ever see you again?
Yes.
At Aberthwaite?
At Aberthwaite.
Get us a coffee. You need to try and open that door now when it stops, not yet.
How do you do it?
You've got to put your arm through the window. And then... Let's have a look. Let's have a look.
Yeah, you got it.
I'm pushing it.
Well done, Claire. You've just opened the door. There we go. I think we're coming to the end of our video now, aren't we?
We are, yeah.
But look at that in the background.
What a day. What an experience. It's well worth it.
Absolutely. Best £20 we spent all weekend.
Absolutely.
So what we're going to do now, we're going to try and find a cafe and get something to eat.
Yeah.
And just soak in the day, really. But the steam, the smell of it and everything. And I just love that cutting there. Look how they've carved into that there.
It's amazing.
They've carved into the stone.
It's fantastic.
Absolutely brilliant day out this. So until the next time, thanks for watching.
Thanks for subscribing.
And we'll see you on the next one. Bye for now.
Bye.
Videoing the train.
I was videoing you, videoing the train.
Let's get some food.